Good afternoon, everyone. Today I am going to read a story, The Perfect Life. And this story is taken from a book, The Old Man and His God, which is written by Sudha Murthy, one of my favorite authors. So let's start this story. Here, children, I refer to Sudha Murthy because she writes this one book from first point of view. Okay, so let's start. Many years ago, I was heading a project in the company where I was working. My team consisted of mostly married women of similar age and background. We were given one big hall to sit in. I had a cabin with a glass partition, while the others sat outside. During lunch hours, the women would sit outside and gossip. They were just loud enough for me to hear them from behind my partition, and I would end up listening to the stories of their households. Most of the women were quite talkative, except for one called Nita. And while the rest used to usually complain about their husbands and in-laws, Nita would be the only one who had anything positive to say about her family. When Neela would grumble about her mother-in-law, Nita would say, "My mother-in-law is like my mother." Then Kusum would say, "My sister-in-law is so jealous of me." And Nita could be heard saying, "My sister-in-law is fantastic. We share everything like sisters." Geeta's husband had a short temper, and she would talk about how he got angry about the smallest issues. But Nita would say she was more short-tempered than her husband. In fact, he hardly ever lost his temper. One day, Nita came to the office wearing a very pretty pink sari. Everyone commented what a lovely sari it was, and I asked her, "Where did you buy it from? Is it your birthday?" Nita blushed and replied, "Yes, madam, it is a birthday gift from my husband." And so we heard stories of her perfect family every day, whereas everyone had the standard complaints of all working women on how they had to juggle their office work and responsibilities at home, where they got little support from their husbands or in-laws. Nita would relate how her father-in-law helped out the kids with their homework and how her husband helped her in the kitchen. It was the common consensus that Nita was a lucky person, perhaps even the eighth wonder of the world. Savitri, the poetess, said Nita's family is better even than the flawed moon. It does not have any defects. Those days of laughter and joking passed, and slowly the group dissolved and each went their own way. Many years later, I got a call from Nita. For some time, I could not place her, but then slowly her stories came back to me. She was Mrs. Perfect. She spoke softly into the phone, and I thought I heard a stress of anxiety in her voice. She wanted to come and meet me one day, and I told her to do so. The day she stepped into my office, I was astonished to see her state. While her friends had progressed from youth to middle age, Nita seemed to have jumped straight to old age. She was frail, and her hair had grayed. We talked for a while about our old team members, but she had no idea where they were now. So I told her, Neela, who used to fight with her mother-in-law and had moved out of the house with her husband, and finally gone back and looked after the old lady in her illness. Kusuma had helped out her jealous sister-in-law when she was in trouble, and Geeta's husband had mellowed down with age and now a pleasant and jovial person to talk to. Life had gone round like a wheel for most of these people. They had taken on the challenge and responsibilities that came with age and faced them with courage. Then I asked Neeta, "So, how are you now? You never had a trouble that these people had." She looked even sadder at my words, and there were tears in her eyes. "Madam, you don't know the problems I am facing."
"You and problems, Neeta?"
"Yes, madam. I am suffering from depression. I have to go to the psychiatrist." "There is nothing wrong with that, Neeta. It is good that you are taking a doctor's help to overcome your condition. It is like going to a doctor for any other ailment. There is nothing to worry about it." "Madam, I have been depressed for so long that the psychiatrist says if I shared it with someone I know and I respect, it might help me. That is why I asked to meet you." "I am glad you thought of me, Neeta. But why are you so depressed? You had such a wonderful family life."
"I always had lots of problems. I just could never bring myself to talk about them. My mother-in-law and sister-in-law were worse than Neela's and Kusum's. My husband always took their side in any argument, and I was so miserable. When my friends would talk about their families, I always wished I could share my story with them. But my mother had told me never to talk ill of my family in public. She said I should always restrain my emotions, and whatever happens at home should put up a happy face outside it. As a result, I would pretend to be happy. For me, being frank meant showing my weakness." I was stunned by her words. I had always thought being frank was a virtue. I was taught to look around me at all the misery that existed in the world and then compare others' problem with my own. I had counted my blessings when I felt sad, and that had kept me going even in my darkest days. Meanwhile, Neeta was still pouring out her heart. "Do you remember that pink sari I wore one day, which everyone commented on and said was so pretty? Even you had asked me where I got it from. I lied that it was a birthday gift from my husband. He has never given me anything on my birthdays. Nobody helped me with my children's homework or in the kitchen. I would struggle all alone trying to do something. My life was so different. My life was no different from my colleagues. But at least they gave themselves the freedom to talk about it and comment in public. I was too busy trying to show I had a perfect life." "Now that you have realized that did not work, forget the past and try to be happy. Nothing comes free. I paid a heavy price trying to keep up the pretense of my life. I suffered from repeated bouts of depression. I tried talking about this with some people, but they did not understand, and I heard some make nasty comments about me. I hope you understand and why I have come to you today and I told you the truth. I took Nita's hand in mine and said to her, "Everyone has secrets. We all have faults that we try to hide. But the problem arises when we do not acknowledge those troubles and faults even to ourselves and pretend to be what we are not. A peacock looks beautiful when it dances, but it cannot sing. A cuckoo is dark, but has a golden voice. That is why a cuckoo should never dance and a peacock should not try to sing. We can live our lives in happiness only when we acknowledge our difficulties and failures and try to overcome them with our strength of character." This is the end of story. I hope you will definitely like it. Thank you. Thank you very much.